One, in which books are opened and throats cleared. Beyond the raging river and the cadaversome chasm, over the mighty mountain in the finest cul-de-sac of a peaceful town, there lived a clever girl.
If a cookie jar contains N ginger snaps, N being more than 10 but less than 20.
A very clever girl. It seemed the cogs in her head were never at rest.
Let D to the N power be a linear differential operator with a continuous right inverse.
Her parents were very proud.
What a clever girl we have, Mother.
Clever, but ill at ease socially, Father. Why does she stay at home with us, listening to the Mystery Radio Nostalgia Hour, instead of necking with boys like I did back when it was way back when?
In time, Mother, in time.
Moll is her name.
Molly is for simps, so.
Moll invented things. Instead of softball trophies and hit parade records, her room was filled with the sound of timber and tools. And Mozart, which they say is good for thinking as well as for making plants grow. And the friction that exists between fresh contraptions and the world as we knew it. But no one really knew what Moll was up to in her head. Sometimes she stayed in her room all day furiously at work. But she always emerged in time to sit around the fire with her folks and listen to the Hilversons brand Hot Dog Mystery Radio Nostalgia Hour.
There we are.
Imagine, for a moment, a hot dog. If the picture that comes to mind is a wiener in a bun, think again. There are a zillion ways to prepare this immortal taste bud tempter. Take the chill out of winter with a hearty hot dog soup. Keep your cool in the summer with a piquant hot dog salad. Best of all, satisfy the gourmet in you by whipping up an Epicurean hot dog delight with the help of Hilversons All Beef Footlong Finest. And now, sit back and enjoy the fifth nail-biting installment of Death and the Music Teacher.
How does it feel to be totally in my power?
It isn't necessary to blindfold me, Mr. Watchell.
This is how we do business, in this business. The foe comes off once I trust you.
I came to you to share something extraordinary. Why would I do anything funny?
Show me something extraordinary, then.
Here, the inscription reads Bologova, and I wondered, could it be? Really and truly, could it be?
Miss Kendrick, what makes you think you say a name like that in Open Sesame? Bologova is a crucial name, this is true. But it is a city name, not a maker. Say you're trying to sell me a car. Say you're a salesman saying,
Watchell, buddy! I got a Detroit here, beautiful 87 Detroit coupe! Runs like molasses in August.
Sounds dynamite. But how do I know that coupe's not a Ford, a Dodge, a Pontiac, or what? It doesn't make sense in the head the way you're speaking. A woman in your position to a man in mine.
You do relish in your little ring of power.
Miss Kendrick, you play like Casals, you look like Garbo.
But that doesn't make you Lee Iacocca in this business.
I'm the smarty in this business. I know all about your guy over there just by looking at him. I can tell from the varnish he ages old. Late 17th century, could be top of the 18th. Any later, they don't have his color in the resin. Clearly, he's been through a lot. Battle scars here, here, and here. That stain. Blood, maybe? Blood from a former owner? Court musician who displeased the queen? Dainty he ain't, but sometimes deformity yields the most distinctive timbre. Anyway, how do I know he's what you say he is? Sight unheard, I mean.
You don't know how a car runs by the paint job.
Or a book by its cover, I tell my students.
I've got to protect myself from charlatans, Miss Kendrick. There are three speechless cellos in the whole wide world that we know of. Two are owned by the Chinese government, which has been trying its darndest to get them to mate. It's near unheard of in captivity. The third one is in the private collection of Baron von Scheibelhausen. And now you've come out of the woodwork telling me you've just happened upon one quite by accident?
Well, it's just awfully fancy to believe.
It would be difficult to believe if it weren't true.
Oh, she's spicy, this one.
I am not!
but I can't make exceptions, even for blue chip dames like yourself. But if this turns out to be a sham, Miss Kendrick, then my man Big Pete will stuff you in that case and toss you down a river, and you can float back to your kindergartners where they're practicing their go tell Aunt Rhody.
Will the sinister Watchel send sweet Miss Kendrick down the river? Tune in tomorrow if your spine can take any more tingling for the next installment of...
That Mr. Watchel gives me the heebie-jeebies.
That Miss Kendrick can come serenade me anytime.
I think you're both loony. Now pass me the pecan hot dog salad.
2, in which Maul discovers her own circuitry. In preparation for the regional science fair, Maul had taken to staying in her room so long that her hair would become a tangled nest and the sweat of mental exertion would trickle down her neck, and Mother would have to bring her dinner,
meatloaf and mashes, and a heaping pile of succotash
to her room on a tray.
Knock, knock.
Mom, I told you never to interrupt me when I make these things.
Maul's temper was as active as her imagination.
Never. It's dangerous.
I don't care if she's some kind of genius, Father. The tone she's been taking.
I can't tell anyone till it's finished. It's
what the devil is she doing in there?
She's making a machine for hearing sounds that can't be heard.
Should be mentioned that there are 2 principal schools of inventing. In the Apollonian school, every particle has its place, every atom is accounted for. In the Dionysian school, the free-form philosophy...
The artistic mess.
To which Maul chiefly subscribed, the inventor gathers whatever suits her fancy. A broken TV antenna.
For tuning.
A woofer.
For...
Was it a tweeter from her father's old stereo?
For amplifying.
The mouth of an antique Victrola.
For listening.
Nearly a mile of copper-plated wire, all told.
For wiring.
And a million more.
A zillion.
More things all piled high.
Glorious. Still.
Something was missing.
A human touch. That's all it needs. A bit of God-designed listening equipment.
And so Maul contributed part of herself to the machine. Literally.
Come out of there!
The tiniest bone in her body, deep in the middle ear.
The stirrup bone, which is just an eighth of an inch long and sometimes go by its Latin name, the stapes.
Took some persuading to dislodge it from her skull, but when the little bone finally emerged, she planted it into the mechanical heart of the machine.
Now part of me will always be with you.
And the whole mess seemed to come, probably, to life. And
just like that,
her familiar room quivered and crackled with previously undiscovered universes. The aching backs of load-bearing walls, dust bunnies stomping like pachyderms across the unswept floor. But nothing was so deafening as the thoughts in her very own head.
Eureka!
Finally, big day of the science fair arrived.
It's easy, it's kids simple. Tune with the antenna with the knobs and presto. You can hear toenails growing on a field mouse. You can hear someone's lying by their breath. You can hear your way through the dark like bats. You can hear the essence of an accident.
Panel of judges, glassy-eyed from an afternoon of praising potato plants and sea monkeys, snap suddenly awake.
The stethoscope attachment permits high precision listening. Objects can tell you what they've overheard. Objects are the best eavesdroppers on account that no one suspects them.
Missy Sperling, is that gum in your...
Mouth off one more time, mister, and you're headed to detention for the rest of your natural...
Life is a great, beautiful adventure.
Except for the parts that make you...
Want to end it. All in single file, or we won't head out to recess. Period.
Comma or question mark. Who can tell me what punctuation belongs?
Here on the equator, we find Kenya, where it is very hot all the...
Time! Pencils down your desk! Pencils!
Down the road from the first little pig lived his brother in the House of Sticks, who can tell me if the state of matter is a liquid, a gas, or a...
Solid citizen wouldn't cut in front of a lady. He would open the door.
Wait till tomorrow is keyboarding skills. If you can't tell your controls from your caps lock, how do you expect to plan for the...
Future of the giant panda is still uncertain. If only man can learn that the world belongs to animals as well as...
People may want to have their hair cut nicely before class. Picture day, because a picture is forever, you know.
Running in the halls, Billy Dumsh.
Any questions?
Even without the aid of the machine, one could have heard a pin drop in a haystack.
I call it the third ear.
Not only did Mull take top honors at the fair,
3 years running,
the third year landed her on American Egghead Quarterly's Junior Overachievers list. She received 14 fan letters, 8 accusations of witchcraft, and 1 creepy phone call.
Mull here.
You're the girl with the machine?
I have a lot of machines.
My clients are prepared to offer you a good bit of money for the blueprints.
I'm not sure you know what you're dealing with.
It's simple. You said it so yourself.
There are still some kinks. It could be very destructive if...
You could be a very rich young lady.
Don't call here again. Creepsters.
Things went back to normal, more or less, until one day she was walking home from math club.
What do you want? I can see you behind that telephone pole.
I've been following you.
Well, cut it out.
Are you the girl?
I'm a girl.
The girl with the machine?
I have a lot of machines.
I'm Garth.
Hi, I'm Mull.
So?
Should be mentioned that these two were at an age of hormonal tumult.
Mull.
Garth.
It's possible Mull would have noticed the faintest similarity between Garth's distinctive phonation.
So?
And the voice on the phone earlier that week. But her recent sacrifice in the name of science had left her somewhat deaf in one ear.
Pardon?
I said maybe I could carry your books.
Oh, here.
Oof! How many classes are you taking?
I like to do a little extra reading.
Like most people, Mull is susceptible to flattery.
I think it's bitching the way you use your head and stuff.
And things moved quickly for the pair.
You're like the sun, the moon, and the stars and all.
He touched her on the cheek, lightly.
Thank you very much.
Very quickly indeed. It felt to Mull like the earth was spinning faster than normal.
This is my room, so...
He touched her on the shoulder, lightly.
Back in my room, I was safe. I was safe, and now here I am in his clutches. This is what you wanted. This is what you wanted, didn't you? You wanted to know what it feels like your place a lot, Garth. The screeching weasel poster really cozies it up. Even if the feng shui could be better, be gentle, he'd better. I'm not one of those smitten by the brute, by the boot. Thanks, Sylvia Plath, but no. Thanks for dinner. I've had buffalo wings with ranch before. Is this a reasonable delicacy, or what is that rather unpleasant boy musk? Is that cologne you're wearing, or what is that? Probably slaps a pint of horse piss under his pits every morning before heading out to tear the wings off of ladybugs. That's what boys do. You think it's hot in here? Seems kind of hot. Maybe I have bad circulation in my extremities. It's not good for the blood to stop talking. Stop talking this instant. Stop.
Stop talking, babe. Relax. Garth's gonna take care of you.
Better take care. You better be delicate. Mrs. Hannerin in sex ed said it's like opening a flower inside of you. She was probably ordered to say that, or else species would cease to put babies on this earth. Feels like it's spinning faster than normal, or is it just me? Thinks the curious contortions of the human body are not for me. Last chance to run, get thee to a nunnery, go!
I'm gonna go put on some mood tunes. You just lie back and let yourself feel all moody-like.
But he certainly, all right! In the hospitality department, maybe you haven't been fair. You probably had a maladjusted childhood. Not every child has fireside radio family time. He probably has a stutter, and that's why he doesn't venture with words containing more than one syllable.
Oh man, Malls. Can I call you that now that we're boyfriend and girlfriend? You. What
are
am
you
I trying
to say?
What did a headstrong inventress see in this ill-groomed monosyllabizer, you may be asking yourself?
What I mean is, you're 100% sexy.
Thank you very much.
Perhaps Mull fancied being the keener of the two. Or perhaps you just fancied the contrast between the hard metal stud in his brow and his long, long eyelashes. Perhaps Garth's heart condition made him seem like he needed her protection. But perhaps most of all, she loved the things Garth was teaching her. To hold a cigarette like Jean-Paul Belmondo. To walk through the streets of a city like they were nothing but her own backyard.
Gotcha something.
Shiny.
To put her skepticism away on a high, high shelf.
I found it on the sidewalk and I thought maybe you could wear it around your neck. That way it doesn't mean we're getting married.
No, no.
But it means I think you're, wow.
To put down her gadgets and pay some attention to her own circuitry, perhaps.
Hey, Malls.
Hmm.
You think you could show me that ear doohickey tomorrow?
What?
I'd be really intrigued to see it.
At any other time, Garth's mastery of a word like intrigued would have raised her suspicions, but Maul was in no place for semantic nitpickery.
Yeah, whatever. It's in my locker. Tomorrow. Come here.
3. In which life imitates art. Or is it the other way around? It seemed to Maul's parents that they hardly ever saw her anymore.
Peaches.
Pumpkin.
Cupcake.
Cutie patootie.
Aren't you going to listen to the Hilberson brand Hot Dog Mystery Radio Nostalgia Hour with us tonight like always?
Garth's gonna call any minute.
Garth with the green eyes.
Garth with the shifty eyes.
I have a problem set due, so we're going to study together.
Invite him over. I made hot dog canapes.
It's only just starting.
The blindfold, Mr. Watchell.
Everything was as you said it would be, Miss Kendrick.
Why then am I still bereft as a bat?
Most unusual. A woman who's true to her word.
Do we have a deal then, Mr. Watchell? Do we have a deal, or do you still intend to send me down the river?
You're a hard-headed woman, Kendrick, but my head is even harder. I can give you the price we discussed, or I can take you from him, forceful-like.
You wouldn't dare! Like birdsong, his music depends on his mood. He plays Bach when he's blissful, and Bach when he's blue. But you know as well as I do, he won't play if he smells danger.
He can't smell anything, woman. He's a bloody cello.
He's a very special cello. He plays notes you can only hear outside your ear.
What are you really in for, Kendrick? You think I don't know what you got here?
You know years. You know makers. You know varnish. But do you know how an instrument can reveal whole worlds of sound? How it enchants, repels, swoops, trembles, triumphs, defeats, whispers, thrumps. How it can do such things that you'd cross the earth to find it. There are more notes, Mr. Watchell, than you or I are fit to hear.
You think I can't make him speak, Miss Kendrick? With my arthritic knuckles and my decidedly unmusical temperament? Think again, music teacher.
Rolls Royce tries just as well for the poor man as it does for the Earl of Ritzyville.
I don't care about your metaphors or your money, Mr. Watchell. I just want my cello to have a safe and proper home where all the world can enjoy his music. I won't surrender him to a bunch of barbarians, Mr. Watchell. Yes,
I told
thugs
you
and
not
barbarians.
To call me again.
Thin ice, Miss Kendrick. Thin ice.
I'd have to be crazy to let you sell him to the highest bidder.
It's wires,
piece by piece.
It's workings.
On the contrary, Kendrick, you'd be wise to pocket the percentage.
You what can't
does that
do
mean,
anything.
Or else.
You can be persuaded, Miss Kendrick.
It's my machine, mine. It came from my head, fully formed, and it has enough juice to destroy noise as we know it. So you see, it's not leaving my sight. Goodbye,
Mr. Watchell. I won't come calling again.
Who was that?
Jenny Doherty wanted my chem notes, so I told her she better go find someone with shakier ethics to copy from.
That's my girl.
Maul waited by the phone all that night, but Garth never called. The next day at school, she opened her locker and found only a note. A note. In a big empty space where her splendid machine, where the third ear used to be.
Dear Maul, I'm afraid you've been had. Our love, I'm afraid, was a hoax. It was the ear I wanted all along. You would have been paid top dollar if only you'd cooperated. I'm not a teen rebel, see? I'm a secret operative, a master of disguise. With a decade of reconnaissance experience, you were seduced by my temporary form, as many are.
Sometimes I'm a beautiful woman with red hair.
Other times I'm a salamander.
Other times I'm an agitated molecule.
Whatever happens to be useful, don't try to find me.
I won't look like me anyway. Sincerely, Garth. Or should I say,
the mercenary.
Four, in which things are heard beyond the reach of hearing. Far from the fine cul-de-sac, past the penumbra of street lamps, a duo with dark intentions was huddling in the darkness. It was so dark, in fact, that no one, including a certain astigmatic narrator, no one, themselves included, could tell exactly where they were.
That you?
Over here.
Ow! I can't see with all this dark.
How do you think bats improved? With a lot of darkness, with a lot of patience, and a lot of perseverance. That's how.
It takes eons to evolve, number one.
Soon we'll hear the grand design, number two. Wait and see.
But I can't see.
Wait.
What?
Did you hear?
No.
Now.
How did you know?
That beat.
There's no mistaking it.
That's called arrhythmia, and it's nothing to laugh about.
Do you have the device?
I told you I'd get it, didn't I?
Hand it over.
Me first.
Me.
We all can listen. It's got an attachment so we all can listen.
But I think we
see low-lying nimbus stratus and stratocumulus in the afternoon giving way this evening to a cool,
clear Filson ice draft. Closest thing to drinking a glacier this side of your...
The future is shrouded in mystery. The Queen of Pentacles here beside the Hanged Man.
So much interference. There must be a way.
There must be a button.
A tuner, perhaps.
Don't you know?
He doesn't know.
Patience. Simply a matter of fiddling.
Fiddling wasn't the plan.
I don't remember fiddling.
The girl wouldn't talk.
What if we...
try this.
Ow! How about...
here.
Here I see great romance. I...
see what you're saying. If the GTCWA is to survive, but it doesn't have the overhead to support what...
did you learn in school today?
Is the first day of the rest of your...
life is good.
Riddance to that dumb mutt. I want a cat.
Skin reveals a growth that must be revealed at...
once with the crust cut off, please.
Put down the cut, John. Please put
that's
it
down
it.
The hatch.
Delicious.
There.
Did you hear?
Water spider on tippy toe.
Wow.
Did you hear? Roots in the earth.
Did you hear? Shipwreck at sea.
All ships wreck at sea.
Some in bays, straits, lagoons.
This one
far from the reach of hearing.
More souls.
From ordinary hearing, that is.
What? What's that?
That I think it's...
An execution, maybe?
Woodchuck chucking wood?
It's... The sound of a broken heart.